So here we are, let's start our guide how to get Phoenix up and running. We start with the research page from the research computing, so rc.cattr.tmu.edu, and we are looking for the help for the instructions. So we go here, help, documentation wiki, research computing wiki page, and on the left down here we have the Phoenix. We need to follow the instructions, right? So step A should have been completed, you have your RAD account, and we're here on the second step where you need to download also MobiXterm, which is a terminal client. Now, we are proceeding to step D, so we need to start our terminal client. And a key for you to remember is that you start MobiXterm, but you don't have to log in on RAD. Okay, this will come afterwards. We're going to use the script for this. So what we are doing is actually starting a local terminal. So we click here, start local terminal. Let me zoom in a little bit. And you need to learn some commands. So by pwd, we can see where we are. And we can also navigate through our folder. We can use the left side here to scroll through the different parts. But it's more interesting to do it with the command. So I want to go to my personal folder, so I click drives. Now every time you write something and then you start typing some letters, clicking tab, it actually moves autofills if there is something to autofill. So it's drive C, and I go to the users folder, so I click tab, and then my username is gkako. Now I don't remember what I have here, so I click ls.la and I see what is in here. It's a big list. These are all my folders and files. So I'm looking for this specific folder, .github. So cd means change drive. Click tab, autofills, and in there I have the Phoenix folder. You don't have a Phoenix folder, so let's make one for you. mkdir, make a new directory, phoenix_demo. Okay. And I get into the folder, cd phoenix. See, if I click many times, I see that I have multiple ones. So _demo. Now, in this folder, I need to bring my script. So I go back to the wiki page here, and I copy this command. Okay, I copy it. I go back. Here, in this command, we are almost like a Linux. So I don't need to paste. If I click the middle button, it actually pastes. And this is the first thing, downloading the script. I need to change my script to executable because by default it cannot. So that's the command. I need now to execute it, I click .dash and the script. This script will log me into the system, into RAD now. So that's my username. And I need to provide my password twice. You can click save. I'm not doing this for this guide. Okay, so that's the second time. And this starts Phoenix. Okay, now if you don't remember, let's go back to the guide. If you don't remember, of course, you can have a look here what you should do. Okay, now the moment you get this command, the next one you need to run is actually this. Okay, that's the next command you need to run. But you would like to go in a specific folder because now, pwd, you're in your home drive. So you would like to make a folder here as well. So make mkdir phoenix demo. And you get into the folder. I have multiple Phoenix folders. Okay, so we want this one. Now here, the guide tells that we should better copy the files. So let's copy this. Now be careful, this is the instruction from Mustafa. What we need to do is we need to copy the demo files in our folder. So I don't need actually to copy it here. So let me do it again. So I need whatever is in that folder, in a folder called demo. OK, and then name I can see now ls.li, I can see the folder there. Okay, that's the folder that I created. Now I can get in there, or I don't have to, it's up to me. What I need to do is run this command. If you don't remember, now by the way, by selecting this, automatically copies this. So if I click the middle button, then you can paste. If you don't remember this, then you can type Phoenix does help, and here we are again. Okay, so I copy this middle button. Now take some time, a new set of instructions. The JupyterLab server has started, so I need to copy one of all these four options. Okay, just copy this one. I don't need to paste to press anything, I just select it. And now I open a browser and just paste the command here. If everything is right, I'm gonna see the logo of JupyterLab, and here I am. And you see that we are actually inside the folder that we just made for Phoenix. Demo is the folder that we copied. And for example, we can go and see if everything is running. So I got demo, Python, documented. These are all the examples similar to the tutorial. So let's try the Boson. And now you see this is a Python script. It's not a JupyterLab. If I double click, it opens, but actually cannot run it. So for me to run, I need to open a notebook. And I need to run one command, load demo poison.py. Zoom in here as well. Now this command just gonna load, control enter, just loads, opens the script. Okay, so this is one cell, everything. Make a new notebook. I can actually rename it if I want. Okay, right click, rename. Run. Test. So automatically it changed up here. And now I can run the code, maybe shift enter or control enter. And I want you to notice that for an instance, this became black, it runs very fast. And this is now happening on the server. Okay. Not on our computer. Can go and change some any aspects of the model. Let's see. Dolphin constant. Okay, I can make this boundary condition 2. Run again the code. Now you don't see the color bar. But that's another part. Okay, how we can manipulate this. The results are also saved in this VDK file. We can use another a tool to show them. And also we also have this image created. Thank you.